The economic evaluation can be performed in a number of ways using various indicators. The values of these indicators for the project at hand define the financial attractiveness of the project. Each indicator has its own meaning for the company, the decision makers, and the project perspective. The final product of our project efforts to make a contribution to the bottom line of our company, or be otherwise valuable to society. That's why we do an economic evaluation to see whether the project will contribute positively to this bottom line. The indicators that are mostly used are payback period, PBB, internal rate of return, IRR, net present value, NPV, and return on investment, ROI. We will not repeat all the definitions here. The indicators are defined in detail in the reading material that is provided for this section. Also, the various formulas will not be explained in detail. In both cases, we refer to the written material. An important concept to make the economical evaluation meaningful is the concept time value of money. The value of money is time related. It is assumed that money in the bank has a higher absolute value in the future than the nominal amount of today. The reason being the interest paid by the bank. Therefore, in the case of an interest rate above zero, the future nominal value of money will be higher than the nominal value today. When today we put 100 euro in the bank, the nominal value of this 100 euro after 5 years will be equal to 122 euro, when the interest rate is equal to 4%. The opposite is also true. Money kept in a safety deposit box will lose value over time as the result of inflation. The nominal value remains the same, but the buying power diminishes. At an inflation rate of 2%, the value of the 100 euro has reduced to a buying power of only 91 euro in 5 years' time. In the economic project evaluation, this aspect is taken into consideration. The projected earnings, the annual cash flows, of the operation are discounted against the defined discount rate. This method is called discounted cash flow, or DCF, calculation. Time value of money is reflected in net present value and IRR calculations. In the table, an example is given of the result of applying different discount rates to the predicted cash flows of a project. Management teams in the industry, tasked with the appraisal of project proposals, will be offered a range of projects. Viewed from a business perspective, a number of categories can be defined. We see strategic projects are to be executed in order to support and bolster the company's strategy, although these projects may carry a higher risk than a debottlenecking project, they may be approved based on a less attractive financial picture. A payback period of 4 years and an internal rate of return below 40% because they serve the mid to long-term strategy. Then you have safety projects. They serve to enhance the safety of production conditions. Execution is based on other considerations than profitability. In order to come up with economic attractiveness, the potential savings of prohibiting accident costs can be taken into account in the profitability calculations. Third, there are the right to operate projects. They have to be executed to stay within the limits of the permits granted. They are also referred to as must projects. Although executing these projects may be regarded as spending money with no revenues as a result, there is a bottom line profitability because discontinuing the operation concerned often has a much higher financial impact. Enterprises have their own minimum levels for appraising projects. An IRR level of 14 to 18% is common, for instance, in the chemical industry at a payback period not over 3.5 years. But again, exceptions exist. The economic project evaluation model requires a set of data. Some come in by definition, like the estimated life of the plant operation, but most are delivered by estimating the capital investment level and the profit that can be made with the result of the project. The most important data are estimated operation life of a plant, the capital investment estimated, the cash flow, and the net profit foreseen, and finally the income statement. A somewhat simplified income statement for a project is given in the table, indicating which data are used in calculating IRR, PV, NPV, PBP and ROI. The business representative responsible for marketing and strategy is to provide data for revenues. Fixed and variable cost is inputted by project engineering and purchasing. With this data available, the economic parameters can be calculated. In real life, the estimated life of the plant and discount rate are well defined for a given project. All data are provided by the business case, depicting the various estimates. Numbers for TIC and TDC estimates are provided by the project cost estimating process. With the feasibility studying being complete, the accuracy level can be as good as plus or minus 10%. The other sets of numbers, those for cash flow and operating net income, used in calculating the economic parameters, are provided by the projected annual income statements. As a final example, we will look at three comparable projects, of which the decision makers have to select one. The three projects, A, B, and C, are similar in capital expenditure, as given in the slide. The difference in the three projects is how they go to the market. A needs market initiation. B is a growing market. And C is a completely new product requiring market introduction. A table summarizing the main indicators that we have seen, that we have been discussing today, is shown here. The four main parameters, PBP, ROI, NPV, and IRR, represent the different aspects of the evaluation. PBP and ROI do not include time value of money. NPV and IRR provide information over the project period and the projected life of the asset. In contrast to PBP, they safeguard that profits in later years are duly reflected. The cash flows of the three projects are depicted in the graph on the left, and the economic indicators are compared in the right half of the slide. Despite higher NPV, IRR, and ROI of project C, the short payback period of project B makes this project tempting for decision makers, especially those with a focus on the near future. The economic project evaluation provides valuable information in the selection process of projects. However, as the uncertainty of these later years' profits in general is high, the accuracy of those two parameters, NPV and IRR, has its limitations. In the project selection and approval process, it is recommended to look at more than only one parameter. In the end, the economic evaluation helps to select the right project to support the company's strategy.